Let me guess. Another new recruit. And you're here to fight for the Pact. Ha! Not likely. You need training. Let's start with an easy task. Mirrored Skin waits at the southern Morrowind Gate with munitions for the siege range. Use the Transitor's Shrine to get there and back. Vother Herendas can tell you more about it.
It's your skin. If you think you're ready, speak with Grand Warlord Zimmerin. Only he can excuse you from training. Go to Mirrored Skin at the southern Morrowind Gate to start training, or see Zimmerin to skip training. Either way, move along.
No end in sight. Anxiety parches my skin. Too many demands, too few supplies. Are you here to soothe or irritate? Ah, blessed moisture. Accept this package of munitions, relieve me of its burden. Take it to Ardalmor on the siege range, beyond the northern Morrowind Gate. He is large and loud, as are all Nords.
Careful. This is a live firing range. Are you supposed to be here? Took your time, didn't you? Olvia mentioned she sent a recruit to fetch these. Since you're here, we could show you the siege weapons. Nothing better than causing massive damage on the battlefield, is there? If you want to know more about rams and oil, talk to Lurtis. For trebuchets, catapults, and ballistae, speak with Looks Forward. You'd better. That's what they're here for. Spend a few minutes using each weapon. Hit the practice dummies with it. Talk to Looks Forward and Lurtis if you want more information. See me when you're done.
Your skill with siege weapons will make a difference in many battles. Learn to use them here. Trebuchets, catapults, and ballistae are dragons of the battlefield, causing massive damage to walls and enemies. I sense the target dummies mocking you. Choose a weapon and punish them. Each type of siege weapon, trebuchet, ballista, and catapult, has unique abilities and uses. Trebuchets fling their missiles against keep walls, dealing great damage. There are three types. Fire pots launch burning oil. Stones smash both walls and soldiers. And ice balls cause damage and ensnare enemies in ice. Ballistae are dear to my heart. They fire fast and true, destroying enemy siege engines, including rams. Standard ballista bolts smash their targets. Fire bolts cause extensive burn damage, and lightning bolts shock and ensnare their victims. Catapults are wonderful weapons against enemy troops. Meat bag catapults spread disease. Oil imparts fire damage, and scattershot causes impact damage. I envy the death you will inflict among our foes with these weapons. Indeed not. Fire them to see. The trebuchet and ballista fire the farthest, while the catapult has a shorter range. Chagrin will visit those who forget this on the battlefield.
Hello.
If you remember that gates are a keep's weak points, you know what tool to use to break in. A ram will crack a keep open like a warhammer on a mud crab. Deploy a ram, get enough soldiers on it to push it up to the keep's main door, then stay with it until the door falls in. There's a vat on top of the platform. Use it as you would any other siege weapon. Don't pour it on me or this useless ram. A ram will crack a keep open like a warhammer on a mud crab. No. Some fool recruit broke our only ram, spoiling the fun for everyone. You can buy your own from siege merchants at gates and keeps. Once you get out on the battlefield, you'll get plenty of chances to use rams.
Done already? I hope so, for everyone's sake. If you want a siege weapon of your own, you can buy them from siege merchants at our gates and keeps. You need to know how to repair walls, doors, and siege engines. Our enemies will batter at our keeps while we bash at theirs. Siege weapons can be damaged too. All this can be repaired. Killing the attackers is a good start. Then repair kits can fix some of the damage. Here's a practice repair kit for a siege weapon. Use it on a trebuchet, catapult, or ballista. When you're done, Galsi wants to talk to you.
Welcome. Behind me is one of the Pact's forward camps. Placing these near a battle site will speed our warriors into the fight, often making the difference between glorious victory and ignominious defeat. Grand Warlord Zimmerin wants every recruit to have a limited version of our forward camps. Full versions can be obtained from siege merchants. Your time here is done. Others need to speak to you. Speak with the Protector Galliel at the Elder Scroll Temple of Chim. He will show you what we fight for.
birds take them! The Elder Scroll of Chim has been stolen! I can tell you of the Elder Scrolls, but you will not feel their holy presence until our scroll returns. Perhaps you can help, once you complete your training. As well you should. All Pact soldiers should covet the Elder Scrolls. It is our destiny to control them all. The simplest understanding of the Elder Scrolls is that they are prophecies. But they are so much more than that. The scrolls contain records of all past and future events. But they cannot be read without blindness, madness, or worse. The Aedra created them, some say. But why or when is unknown. The temples are holy places, created as housing for the scrolls, to honor and protect them. We built them upon the soil of Cyrodiil, close enough to the battlefields to bestow their blessings upon our troops. The Grand Warlord orders these attacks. Access to each scroll is blocked by a gate. To unlock it, both keeps protecting it must be taken away from the alliance that holds the scroll. Once the keeps are captured, the way to the temple is open. The Elder Scroll must be taken from its temple and brought to one of our six original keeps. Once there, it must be placed upon a scroll pedestal. Needless to say, capturing an Elder Scroll requires the cooperation of many soldiers. It is our destiny to control all the scrolls. Every Elder Scroll we hold grants power to all the soldiers of the Pact. This is another reason our enemies cannot be allowed to keep any of them. Books in this temple contain information about the Elder Scrolls, if you wish to know more. Grand Warlord Zimran needs to speak with you when you're done here.
near the end of your training, soldier. Now to tell you of capturing the enemy's keeps and resources. All resistance must be crushed. When our banner flies boldly atop the flagpole, all know the Pact has conquered again. For keeps, we must breach walls or sunder gates to reach the heart of the enemy stronghold. None of this will be easy. The Pact is destined to rule Cyrodiil. Each keep and resource we conquer is a step toward this goal. Your participation in these actions enables you to acquire equipment and weapons from Pact siege merchants. I decide the direction of the Pact in Cyrodiil. Dreet carries my orders to the generals Darlieurs and Jegord. They post these to the mission boards for all to see. General Darlieurs will tell you more.
I extend the claw of welcome, warrior.
The Grand Warlord has much on his mind. Be grateful for a few minutes of his time. To me come Grand Warlord Zimmerin's orders. These I post to the boards that flank me. Which should we discuss? Even the newly hatched can understand bounty missions. The task is to kill enemy soldiers. All that lives must die. These missions seek to hasten that day for our enemies. Information is critical to our efforts. A scouting mission sends you to a target deep in enemy territory. The Swamp Eel sees, but is not seen. Be the Swamp Eel, then return here. General Jegord supervises the other missions. Speak with him to learn about them. He glares at us from across the way. Do not be shy. Jegord hisses loudly, but seldom bites.
Yes? What is it? Got tired of you pestering, eh? Very well. I administer the battle and war front missions. Go ahead, ask me about them. Battle missions send small groups of soldiers to capture enemy resources. Each keep is supported by a farm, lumber mill, and mine. Denying the enemy these resources is the first step to claiming that keep for the Pact. A warfront mission targets one of the enemy's keeps. Controlling keeps is the key to conquering Cyrodiil. This is a major effort, though. Go in without a large force, and you're all going to die. There's always more to learn, but the battlefields will be your teacher from this point on. The mission boards await. Start with a scouting mission. You're less likely to die on one of those. Welcome to the war.